Hello, my darling. Welcome to the Shamanic Heart Space podcast. I am Nancy and I welcome you to this episode, which is all about the Gemini new moon of June 2023. Please take what resonates and leave what doesn't. What's important here is that you take some time out for yourself to connect with what messages come through for you. Some of the things I say may resonate, may not resonate, because this is a collective reading. I'm not an astrologer, but I do interpret the messages that I receive via channeling regarding the energies around new and full moons every month. This is to help people get aligned and stay on track with this rather wild time on planet Earth that we're sharing. And as always, if you want to know more about me and what I do, just visit my website, shamanicheartspace.org. Okay, so let's get into it. If you're new here, just get yourself nice and comfortable. Perhaps you're out on a walk. I like to try and start with a bit of breathing to get back into the body, especially as everything's been moving so fast recently. We can just take a few deep breaths together. Get into your center. Where are you now in your physical space, in your energetic space? Is your mind super active? Do you feel hyperactive? Okay. So, we're coming to the end of Gemini season with this new moon. The moon cycles flipped, but you may know that already, so that we get a full moon before a new moon at the moment. This will be going on for quite a while. But if you're feeling a bit topsy-turvy, this is partly the reason. We feel much more aligned and centered in general if the new moon comes first. I can't really explain why, but just the rhythms and cycles of nature. Obviously, when they're in a certain rhythm that we're used to, we are part of that rhythm. So when it changes, we can feel a little bit off kilter. Gemini is associated really with the throat, the lungs, the breath, the nervous system, as well as the hands. So depending on where you're at and what's going on in your life, you may notice some things with those areas. Maybe anxiety, maybe problems around the voice, maybe issues, the skin on the hands, that sort of thing. And the nervous system, so it's going to be really important to keep your nervous system, keep yourself calm all the time, but especially at this time, because it feels like there's a lot going on. I'm starting to tingle, get the information now, so just bear with me. I receive messages through images and words and feelings. I have to interpret them to pass them on to you. So yeah, it certainly feels like there's a lot going on, and you don't have to be psychic to be aware of that right now. There's a lot of going on in the direction of new beginnings, for sure. Before a new beginning, some things have to end. And that can be difficult. There's a lot of information kind of coming at us. So I'm not just talking about the usual ways one might receive information, like, through actually going, sitting down, learning, getting a vision of somebody going to a library now, because I would not advise taking any information from the media these days. But what I mean by information is it's coming from the cosmos, it's coming from above, information in the forms of like upgrades and DNA activations. So it's a lot to take in, it's a lot to process. If you're new here, you won't be aware yet that when I channel, sometimes I yawn or breathe a bit funny. Sometimes my voice changes, so Just bear with me if you hear that happening, okay? So just give yourself time. I'm getting pain in my head right now. You know, this could feel very overwhelming and rushed over this mood. There's a huge amount of realizations and things coming to the surface, coming to the light. So integration and implementation are going to be quite important around this time, so that things don't just get jammed up in your head and cause you to get a headache. Give yourself space, give yourself time to digest. You may need to slow down so that you don't get completely overwhelmed. Okay, so this could feel like anxiety. It could feel like the heart racing, not able to switch the mind off, difficulty catching sleep. So it's going to be quite helpful to contemplate what's going on, but not getting lost in the thoughts. So being an observer, a little bit detached. The ways you could do this are through focused breathing patterns, techniques. Doing your practices, maybe getting a massage or a Reiki session if you're in a position to do so, if that resonates with you. Because the thing is, you're not a machine, darling. And this really looks like there's too much data going into the machine. Yeah, so slow down. This is all happening so that you could expand, not explode. They do have a sense of humor. So being conscious with the energy as well as your energy is really important now. You might find yourself just wanting to go to sleep all the time, but unable to because your schedule is too busy or you're just very restless. So getting into grounding yourself, there's a billion and one ways to do that. If you're not sure, get in touch with me. But it's likely to feel quite restless, really feeling this in the feet and the legs, actually too busy. So what you could do is focus on what is important, and you can ritualize, you can learn to enjoy your routines and your obligations. They're saying to me, sit with that, especially enjoy your routines and your obligations. So sometimes when we are buzzing around super fast, we can maybe feel resentful, feel like we're carrying too much of the load, the burden, there's not enough hours in the day. But we can look at what is happening, where we're choosing to spend our energy, and see where we can streamline, if there's anything that needs to go, if there's anything that's no longer serving, because we're changing very quickly at the moment. So something that really resonated with you before just may not be resonating with you now. So sitting with that over this time, and feeling into it as much as possible. This is not really head stuff, even though it could really seem that way. Like there's lots of thinking that needs to be done, but you'll go further if you lean into your intuition and you lean into your heart rather than trying to sort it all out with the mind, all right? So again, looking at your everyday life, is your routine working for you? And are there ways that you can find to make that routine? If there are things you have to do, I used the word obligations before, if there are obligations that you need to fulfill every day, every week, every month, can you make that a little bit more enjoyable somehow? Ritualizing, making a ceremony out of things, your evening routine, what does that look like? Okay, so we really can expect a lot of information, communication, new learning to come through. So I'm getting a vision of somebody with their crown chakra really open and lots of information pouring in that way. So if you can feel curious and inquisitive with this, that will take you a long way, rather than getting sucked into just, yeah, getting washed away with that overwhelm. So it's likely that a lot of people are going to have these realizations, these awakenings. There's this huge awakening going on at the moment. So you can probably expect to learn something that could alter your direction, especially after an integration process, picking up something new or just deciding, yeah, I don't want to do that anymore. So this time is really for gathering information, changing up your routine to suit you better. Okay. So be aware that we're all students as well as teachers. We are both. You have medicine for others and they have medicine for you. It's really important to be yourself and to be humble in yourself, in your everyday life. Okay, so at this time, take note of the people around you in your day-to-day life, your neighbours, your friends, your colleagues. There are collaborations that could spring up. There are friendships that could spring up. Maybe somebody that you didn't even notice before who's been nearby you a lot. They seem different to you. You spring up some kind of connection. So, yeah, again, this is about your immediate environment. Oh, bit of a change in the energy here. One sec. Okay. Okay, so with this moon, you really could start seeing some things very differently. So with that, some new intentions could spring up. So if you've been keeping like on track with following the rhythms of the moon cycles, or keeping any kind of journal, so that the people who've been working with me for some time, you can go back and look over where your intentions have maybe shifted over time. And now that you realize more and you're going to become feel a bit clearer soon. If you don't feel that clarity right now, just give yourself some space to allow the clarity to drop in. The clarity is there, always. It's just sometimes you just got to let the dust settle a little bit, okay? Okay, so they're saying to have a look at what's unfinished in your life and tie up any loose ends. So you might need to write a list of anything that you need to close out. You may need to ritualize anything that needs to close out, some kind of ceremony. Okay. And this could include daily stuff too. Are there any emails you need to respond to, any calls you need to make, any texts you need to reply to? Because this Cancerian solstice is coming up, so we're stepping into a new chapter yet again. So tidy up whatever you need to so that you don't take old energy into a new space. We're constantly opening new chapters and starting new cycles at the moment, so it's really important to keep your energy clean so that you're not leaking energy into other areas of your life. Okay, so there really could be a temptation to add more to your life because with so much information coming through, so many changes taking place, there's a risk of getting overloaded. So just hold your horses. Have a look at your plate. Is everything on that plate good for you? Just stick with this metaphor because that's what they're showing me. So, are there any adjustments that you need to make? Once again, so this is the main theme, really, is making adjustments, not bringing old energy into a new space. All right, so many people will be, it's like a stubbornness, showing me a donkey. This, if you are feeling stubborn, stuck, oh, fed up, that energy, it's likely coming from tiredness, maybe fatigue from just feeling confused, not knowing which direction to go in, just feeling stuck. Oh. So please remember that you are expanding, you are rising. If you feel stuck, this is just a piece of the puzzle that you haven't seen or made sense of yet. You don't need to rush anything. This could also be an opportunity to let something go without overthinking it. Just, that's not for me anymore. Okay, let's go. If there is something driving you particularly crazy that you feel stuck on that's causing you pain and has been for a while, maybe you just need to drop it and let it breathe a bit, and so that you can hear your intuition. There could be a struggle right now between the mind and the heart, the intuition. So it's really important to give that some space. All right, so this could be really uncomfortable because we're being asked to trust the unseen. I'm laughing because I'm like, what again? This is our new way of being now. Kings, queens, and everything in between. This is our new way of being. I know that there is a want, a desire, and a lot of people that they want all the facts, all the info, but it's just not there. It's just not there. We're in this liminal space at the moment, and we're, flying. We're free falling. We're flying. But that is how doubt can creep up through self-sabotage and, fear. Just, right now, don't give the ego too much of a platform. The mind will really want to talk you out of things and create a nightmare so that you stay stuck. So just, keep that ego tame as best you can. And things are moving, things are changing. So just do your best to chill, let it unfold. Let it unfold. Don't have all the information yet. And I know that's easier said than done, but by leaning into intuition and surrender and creating calm space for yourself is going to carry you a long way, relaxing as much as you can. Because if the body is in fight or flight or freeze mode, nothing's going to move. Okay? So this is a really great time to journal as well. If it's a practice you haven't tried for a while or never, now's a great time to pick it up just to get things out of your mind. Okay, so balance and harmony is coming. It's just some stuff that for whatever reason we're not meant to know yet with the mind anyway. Hang on a sec. So yeah, again, the sense is this is a process. So just let things settle down. Feel into what you want in your life. Feel into that and allow the clarity to come in its own time. So you can, feel into what sorts of things get you excited, what brings joy to you, what gets you in that higher vibration. If you're feeling, stuck in energy and emotion and whatever that you don't like, it's like really mind over matter is coming to me now. It's just like, okay, this is how it is, but how do I want it to be? And I'm going to focus on that. And you don't even need to take action yet, but just getting into the vibe of that, into the feeling of that. And so also, can you do something creative or be more creative? This is a great way to get stuff out of your system, and to utilize the amount of information and energy that's coming through right now. Okay. So pay attention to your ideas or lack of ideas, lack of answers, and lack of clarity, because the next full moon will bring the energy, will bring through clarity and what steps that you need to take. So don't worry, everything passes, everything goes in cycles. So coming up to the next moon, which one is that? The Show Me Capricorn. So I guess it's going to be a Capricorn full moon. Ooh, so we're talking practical energy and knowing what to do. All right, so yeah, clarity's coming. You can always rely on Capricorn for that clarity, how to be practical, and whether that's move ahead with something or leave it behind. So just be patient, just be in the process, all right? Less stress, more bliss, and finding ways to feel that joy every day, just keeping things simple. You don't want to be doing more. Okay, my lovely. I hope that you found this episode helpful. Thank you for the ongoing love and gratitude and support that you're sending me all the time. I feel it and I appreciate it. And you're helping me a lot, so thank you. Thank you for listening. Thank you to my amazing supporters who make it possible to do a free episode. And listen, you are doing great. You're still here. You're still pushing on through. And sometimes, showing up is all you need to do. You are enough. Showing up is enough. And we are in this together. None of us is alone, even though it can feel like that sometimes. But that's just an illusion. I'm sending you loads of love. I'm sending you loads of love, and I hope to see you at the Maloka. So check out Patreon and my website if you want more support for your consciousness journey. You can come to Peru to work with ayahuasca or join me at a workshop in London. I've got one happening on the 18th. The other ones are sold out. There's a couple left for the 18th. If you want to check that out, check out the show notes. And I'm also serving medicines in one-to-one sessions for the next few weeks. It's all on my website. Before I head back to Peru, please turn on your notifications so you never miss an episode. And consider a 5-star review if you found this helpful so that others can benefit too. So thank you once more, and I'm sending you so much love and wishing you the most positive time and energy over this Gemini new moon. Take care. I'm Nancy, and this is Shamanic Heart Space.